This is the end. To-do-do, my only friend, the end. Ruchak!
Time for the danger.
Gdje je kokoš?
Ne marš napolje. Marš napolje! Marš napolje! Marš ti napolje! Hajde svi marš napolje! Marš! Marš!
Konkurs u Francusku. Traže ljudi scenarije za ostalog psi.
O, veliki je stih, gospodin. Daj Bože. Time out!
Alhamdulillah, how you guys doing? We're continuing our trip in Bosnia, meeting some wonderful people, no exception. Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum. Assalamu wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
May the peace and blessings of Almighty God, Allah, be upon you.
And you too.
Now, you're someone who we have like in America, you have Hollywood. I've been to India, you got Bollywood.
Yeah.
You're an actor here, and what do they have here in Bosnia? What is it called?
Grbavica Wood.
Grbavica Wood.
Yeah, maybe. Because it's my neighborhood.
So you're also you're an actor, right? You're a well-known actor here in Bosnia. Tell us some of the work that you've done. And
my name is Alexander Saxon. I'm employee of the National Theater in Sarajevo. I actually finished the Academy of the Performing Arts at 1998. I'm 49 and I'm working in National Theater as an actor.
Yeah. MashaAllah. So tell us, we started off with this special greeting. Jesus greeted with that greeting.
Yeah.
Abraham, Moses, all the messengers of God Almighty, Assalamu alaikum, peace be with you.
Of course.
But someone might think, because there's a lot of misconception, they heard your name, right?
Yeah.
Alexander. So you have a background, Serbian background?
No, actually, I grew up in ordinary communist family, actually. Mm-hmm. I mean, it was like, before the war, we didn't, you know...
No religion. More atheist? Actually.
But not actually atheists, but, you know, we didn't thought about that, you know, as something which is important, you know. Uh-huh. So I grew up in that kind of family, you know, but I'm from mixed marriage. My father was Orthodox, but he wasn't actually, you know, a strong believer. And my mother was a Muslim. After the war, I grew up with my father, and I, you know, didn't communicate with religion at all.
Yeah.
But, you know, during the war, I start to think about God, you know, in proper manner, I think.
Mm-hmm. But before that, there was no thinking about it.
No, just like, you know, it was like, you know, not too much.
Yeah. So during the war, is it because now you were starting to see, like, my life can go at any time?
Yeah, but I think when you are in extreme situations, you know, the soul is connected with God, definitely. So you start to think about God and ask help, mm-hmm. you know, but because, you know, we saw that people can't help you in some kind of situations, definitely. You know, especially when your life is in danger. Mm-hmm. So I start to think about, you know, God, because I actually survived in some kind of situations which logically and statistically I should be dead.
You should be
definitely,
dead.
Definitely.
Yeah.
So
you started to reflect, like, purpose. What's my purpose? Yeah, why am I here in this life?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Because you start to watch, you know, things and situations around you in different manner. Uh-huh. And, you know, thanks to Allah, I'm where I am now.
Now, this is something that for some people, it's, you know, back home in America, You can be an American, you're an American, and now you can be Christian. You can be an American, you can be Buddhist.
Yep.
You can be American, and you can be Muslim, right?
Yes,
it's no big deal. But here, we see that a lot of times people attach to their nationality a religion, like if that's from God and that is connected and you can't separate the two. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah. Excuse me, I think that's stupidity, really.
Isn't it, right?
And that's misunderstanding mm-hmm. of everything. Because, you know, example is my name. When I was at Hajj in 220.
So, mashallah, you went to Hajj also?
Yeah.
Oh, alhamdulillah.
I asked one scholar in Mecca about my name. Do I have to change my name? He asked me, what's your name? I said, Alexander. Oh, he said, that's Iskander on the Arabic.
Mm-hmm. What is it in Arabic?
Iskander.
Iskander.
Yes.
Alexander
Iskander.
Iskander.
And he told me, no. Mm-hmm. Leave your name as example for people.
Bravo.
You know.
Yes.
Because I think my name has a nice meaning. It's like some who help people.
That's what it actually means.
Yeah. So I choose to keep my name. Maybe in the future I will just put one originally Muslim name,
yeah.
You know, with this one. But I think that's, you know, formality. The purpose of Islam is heart. I think
it's not about names now.
It's not about names, and you know the you know that some kind of manifestations which are really not so important for people, for everything.
But people sometimes they focus on that. Obviously, if there's something like this is a wise scholar, because obviously if there's something like the name has a bad meaning or something, but your name didn't, and it represents that. Hold on, Islam transcends nationalism.
Yes,
and there's a statement of the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, who he said, beware of this nationalism. It stinks.
Of course,
you know this hadith, right?
Of course,
and this is what pretty much divided almost like this country, isn't it? In Bosnia, can you tell us because of this nationalism? I heard the people are getting along. You know, everything was pretty good. And then the politicians and people, correct me if I'm wrong, they started to push this nationalism.
Of course. And I think that's completely wrong. You know, the Islam, especially religion, especially Islam, is above that.
It transcends that, yes.
You know, and the Hajj is, you know, really beautiful, you know, example.
Example
for that,
of that,
The people
from all over.
From all over, you know, different colors, different nationalities, different backgrounds. Everything is so beautiful, and you are surrounded, you know, with millions and millions different brothers and sisters, and that's the beauty of Islam, really.
Isn't it? So you can be at Hajj, and you can be praying with someone who's from Croatian.
Yes.
A Serb from Serbia, right? A Chinese,
Afghan.
But we all lined up together, shoulder
course,
to shoulder, worshiping the one God.
Of course. That's beauty.
Isn't that beautiful?
Yes, definitely, yes.
Yeah, definitely. So tell us now, I have a friend, actually one of my students, haven't seen him in a long time. He's also Serbian. And he approached me and he said, oh, I like your show. I was watching the Dean's show and whatnot. And he started like talking about some shows I did years ago. About one was, I believe, the top 10 reasons Jesus, who many people don't know, that you have to, and I'll get into that a little bit later. But the show was titled Top 10 Reasons Why Jesus Is Not God. Right? And then mm-hmm. proving that he's a messenger.
Yeah, I saw that show.
You remember that show?
Yes,
He saw that show and some other shows, and he's just very interested, and we're talking. He agrees with everything.
Definitely.
But now it seemed like, you know, what is my, you know, family going to say? What's my community going to say? So it's like the courage wasn't there. Do you see a lot of this?
These are obstacles, you know, mm-hmm. which, you know, the people have to jump over.
Yeah.
To be free. Mm-hmm. What will my family say, friends, you know, surrounding, everything. It doesn't matter. Because they can't help you at the judgment day. Mm. Definitely. We will have no use of them. Only you and your deeds. And that's the point, I think. So we have to, you know, to put that beside us, mm-hmm. definitely. And that's my advice to all who have, you know, dilemma about, you know, starting to practicing Islam, just go over that.
Mm-hmm. Have you had some dilemmas?
Because we don't have much time, actually. We don't have,
no.
You know, the our hour will come, definitely. We don't know when.
We don't know when death is coming.
Definitely.
Yeah.
You know.
Tell me, have you had actual real situations where someone, you start talking to them and they know you're a Muslim? And simply one is, a Muslim is simply one who has submitted themselves to God alone. How do you translate that in Bosnian? Onaj ko se predo
Bogu.
To je musliman, that's it.
To je musliman.
Some people think, oh, you're musliman, oh, ti sta trčin. Have you heard that?
Yeah,
is that something that's
yes,
common?
Definitely.
What because, do you say to someone?
That's because they connect us with Turks when we spoke about
Islam. Oh, ti si postao Turčin?
Da. Da.
So what do you say to someone like that?
You know, I
it's kind of silly, right?
Yeah, it is. Because, you know, the Islam exists, you know, way before Turks.
Yeah.
You know, that's also stupidity, yeah. Really.
The first man, Adam... Christians believe in him. He wasn't a Christian. He didn't hear about Christianity.
In some sort of way, we are all brothers and sisters.
We all come from the same
definitely.
Father, Adam.
Yes.
He submitted his will to what? To God.
To God.
And a Muslim is one who submits his will to God. When you explain these things, if someone is open-minded, That goes back to, have you had some positive interactions where people, there's ignorant
definitely,
people. Tell me about the positive, tell us
more
about
positive, more positive reactions than negative,
yeah.
Really. Yeah.
Do you see that more like in the university, like in people who are, I've seen they invited some Muslim scholars there in the University of Belgrade, people that aren't from these isolated places where they don't have, let's say, more information. People in these universities, Belgrade and whatnot,
yeah.
Who are more in the metropolitan areas that are more open-minded. Is there a difference there?
I think the main problem here is we don't think much about non-Muslims here.
No?
You know. To invite them, you know, that's the example of you know the best you know scholars,
yeah,
like Khalid Yasin, you know. Mm-hmm. The purpose of his da'wah is to invite non-Muslims, mm-hmm. on his, you know, kako se kaže, lectures. No, we don't do that here much.
Why?
I don't know why. You know,
but that's the whole essence of Islam.
That's the question we have to ask our scholars.
Yeah.
Really. Our scholars.
Yeah.
That's important.
That's the essence. If you open up the Quran, it's da'wah. It's inviting, you know, people to this this way of life that brings peace, to bring solace. That and it's for everyone. And again,
because if I you know come to some lectures, I actually. Know most of that stuff I you know heard of.
Yeah.
But for the non-Muslim is you know is more important to
and I usually say the not yet Muslim, right?
Actually not yet Muslim.
You know
definitely.
Why I say that? You know
definitely,
what we say? Because everyone, be he a Serb, be a Croatian,
definitely.
Has the potential
definitely.
To give birth to what's already inside of them,
definitely,
right?
Definitely.
Everyone can submit to God, right?
Definitely.
So
we have to wake up that point.
Wake that up, yes.
Really.
What's the top misconception or misconceptions that you've seen that many Croatians or Serbs, people outside of Islam, that they have about Islam here in this part of the world?
Yeah, I think the tradition is a problem.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Talk about this. So it's not like terrorism and whatnot, thinking that, oh, you're Muslim, because back home, I was at the place where they have the castles outside of Mostar.
Yeah.
And these people, I love interacting, making the human connection.
Yeah.
They're from Australia.
Mm-hmm.
And we sat and we talked, and I'm saying, the Adhan, oh, the Adhan's going on. Do you know what that means? No. And I said, oh, that means God is great. Come to prayer. They're like, wow, you probably heard the Salaam Alaikum,
yeah.
Peace be with you. How do you say it? Nek yamir stobo.
Yeah, amir stobo.
That's beautiful. But then I said, they start talking about ISIS. I said, why? I call it the insane state, right?
Yes. Daesh. Yes.
They have nothing to do with Islam. So that's what I mean when I mean misconceptions. Definitely. Is it the same thing amongst Serbians, Croatians, you know?
Some of them.
Some of them?
Some of them, yeah.
Yeah? But tell me about what you were saying, this tradition. What were you trying to...
I think we are trapped with tradition here, yeah? You know. That's the main problem, mm-hmm. I think.
Mixing like culture with religion?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we have to use our translator.
Yes, go ahead, please.
Mislim da je glavni problem to zašto što nas tradicija nekako zarobljava i spriječava da o islamu razmišljamo na način ono koji bi nas negdje oslobodio.
Brother is saying that actually the tradition is like a chain, as a prison for people in these areas or Balkans in general, that is trapping us and prohibiting us from thinking about Islam as a option, as a open option for everybody. Mm-hmm. Because tradition puts this burden on your back that you have your parents mm-hmm. and grandparents, they're always like this, you cannot change it if you're born. Mm. Yeah.
You have to die, sir.
I see.
When
so,
say you even have Muslims, when somebody enters Islam from the Serbs or Croatians, they say, "What kind of person is this?"
Yes,
yes,
and that's yeah,
How you say, Islam is something, it's not inherited. Like, you can inherit money.
Yes.
You can inherit, you know, some belongings, personal goods. But Islam is, you have to make a conscious decision. Is this the truth? Is it not? You have to willingly submit yourself, right?
I think that's the question of the truth and lie.
Exactly. So you have to come a point in your life to discern, is this really from the Creator consciously? You're not just like a robot going through the motions and the movements, right? So people say, I'm a Serb, I'm going to die a Serb. I'm a Croatian, I'm going to die. Okay, you die in that natural, but what's your way of life? You know what I mean? Are you worshiping the creation or are you worshiping the Creator? And that's what Islam is calling to, transcending all of these nationalism and all that other thing. I see what you're saying. That's people are stuck with blinders there, right?
Yeah.
That's a big problem. And it's interesting you say that because I had an individual, we were talking about dawah, and dawah is just, how would you translate?
Pozivati.
Pozivaš kući, nekome kod kuće na kafu, što ga ne, nećeš ga maltretirati. Meaning you're not going to like beat him up or whatnot. Svašta pričaš, što ne pričaš od cilj života, purpose of life, što si stvoren. Eh?
Da.
Neka samo ješti, piti, spavati and then umreti.
I umreti.
doesn't make sense. So that's when we say dawa, pozivati. You know, so someone, is this goes with that tradition where people feel like, oh, kako će on biti bolji ako je on sada, because you have situations where someone comes from a Serbian background. He's a better Muslim than this guy who is born Muslim. Yeah. We see that, right?
Yeah.
But people, they think that's not possible.
I think it is.
It is, absolutely it is.
Definitely.
It's possible. How is it not?
Because when he's, aware of his creator, he knows what kind of life he lived before.
Oh, yeah.
And that's, like salvation for him. Mm-hmm. And it's normally that he grabbed that, heart and became better man and for everything, for all around that. For family, for friends, for neighborhood.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Because the other one, maybe he takes for granted. He's not even praying,
definitely.
Right?
Yes.
Maybe he's drinking alcohol, right? Maybe he's still girlfriend, boy, doing stuff, some of them. But this guy, let's say he's Serbian, for instance, right? But he's looking, Trinity, Odbija, someone dying for your sins. How you say the atonement in Bosnian?
Kažnjavanje.
Kažnjavanje, neko umro za tvoje grehe. Ne, Odbija. A vidio Islamu da, hej, nema to, samo Boga, samo obožavaš stvoritelja, just worshiping the Creator.
Yeah.
And he starts praying, on počne 5 vakata klanjati, čita Kur'an, oženio se, ostavio varanje, kockanje, a ova još to radi. How can the other guy still do that? How are they going to be the same?
Yeah.
So that's a great example right there.
Of course.
And do you see that happening?
Yes, I have many friends. I have many friends in my surrounding, which changed their lives completely.
Yeah.
And became a better man. My very best friend became better man.
Yeah.
Really.
And that's thinking outside the box of that tradition.
Definitely.
Yeah. Amazing. Definitely. So tell us a few more things I want to... What are some of the challenges that you had with your family now? Many people, they end up realizing...
Thanks to God, yeah. I didn't have problem with my father at all.
No?
Yeah. And I really praise Allah to have mercy on him. He was really nice and kind to my faith.
Mm-hmm. So he didn't...
No, he really, he fully respected my decision and he didn't make the troubles at all.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just interviewed a young lady from Ghana.
Yeah.
And her parents took her in the jungle. She accepted Islam.
Yeah.
And literally, that's they took her in the jungle to try to get some witch doctor to say, get this shaitan out of her, get this devil out of her. Oh, and a priest God. And whatnot, but she still held on.
Of course.
And they disowned her and whatnot, so this is a blessing, yeah, because more than just a shekirom come.
Actually, my mother is so happy.
She's very happy, huh?
She's very happy because I think that was her, you know, great wish for me.
That's amazing.
Because she's also, you know, the religious, my brother, mm-hmm. my sisters. Mm-hmm. Actually, I think that's the mother's dua for us, yeah, because we are all believers, mm-hmm. and thanks to Allah, we really, you know, live nice lives.
Uh-huh. Do people, when they hear this word Allah, you know, who are not Muslim?
It means God, on Arabic, it's like Jehovah, like, you know, Lord.
Yeah. That's it.
I don't have problem. I don't understand why people have problem. You know, because the people connects the word Allah just for Arabs and Muslims. No, it's Arabic. You know, even I think Jews say Allah in you know
Arabic Arabic reading Jews.
Arabic reading Jews. Yeah.
Many people don't know in the Bible in Arabic it has Allah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Elohim. I don't understand.
Yeah, in Aramaic, you know, Aramaic, the original language Jesus spoke, he said Allah.
Yeah.
Allah.
Da.
It's there. Yeah.
Of course.
So this is talking about the one supreme being, the creator of the heavens and earth. So these are those things that when people hear these, the simplicity, the definition of Islam, you know, people who are open, you know, it draws them in. Tell me, there was this... I think in Belgrade, it was amazing to see this. I think he was some celebrity. I'm not sure. You might have seen it. He was talking about, he's a priest or somewhat, and he was out there talking about the respect that he had because the Islam was, and the Muslims were protecting their women, right? Mm-hmm. Did you see that?
Yes,
do you know this guy?
No, he was actually actor before.
Oh,
I think.
He was.
Yeah,
tell us about that.
I think, but I don't know much about that man. Just you know, few sentences. But he was, I think.
What was he saying? Do you remember what he was saying about
Actually, he spoke about, you know, how the Muslim men treated their women.
Yeah.
You know, and. Pričao je o čednosti žene muslimanke i o tome kako one zapravo čuvaju svoj stid i ovaj čednost.
Kako su oni izgubili te vjernike.
Da, a Korio jest. Da, da.
He was basically condemning his own people and giving them Muslims as a positive example, saying like, look how Muslims conduct with their women, how they protect their women and how their women dress. He was also talking how Muslim women protect their chastity, cover themselves. So he said this in America that they lost this value in them and he gave Muslims as a positive example of this.
Mode, kako danas treba izgledati, kako treba se kretati ulicama, znate, to je strašno. Mi vrlo često, kažem, to smo baš pominjali u razgovoru pre ovoga, neki put se tako, mi hrišćani, tako sprdamo se, kao, eto, kažem, vidi ove muslimanke, onako zabradile se, pa sve, kao, šta izigravaju? Kako šta izigravaju? Ma oni, bre, sačuvaju, oni spasavaju svoje devojke, svoje žene. Jer, u stvari, jedno društvo zavisi od zdrave žene. Od zdrave, čedne i moralne devojke. Zašto kažu da Nemci ne mogu ništa Turcima u Nemačkoj? Zašto?
Sačuvali su porodično.
Sačuvali su svoje žene. Svoje žene su sačuvale. Ona se obukla. Jeste ono to malo čudno izgleda, neobično za ovo društvo, znate. Ali ona je ipak čuva neku svoju čednost, neki svoj moral. A vidi, pogledaj ti mlade hrišćanke danas, Srpkinje, ove po Beogradu, po Podgorici, ne znam, ovdje ne poznajem ove krajeve, pretpostavljam da isto svuda. Iscepane, ogoljene, izbušene, istetovirane. Pa šta su to? Znači, to je sve u stvari reč. Priđi, stavi ruku na mene i vodi me da hoćeš. Čekajte, pa ne mogu da verujem da je bilo šta drugo. Da ona kaže, stanite, ja sam sad jedna fina devojka, kad je ona skroz gola, kad ima u pupku piercing, kad ima, znate, kad joj se sve vidi. Znate, danas je ta moda tih tesnih farmerki, znate. Pa onda bolje izađe gola, kak je vezima. To je kao hula hop, to je toliko priljubljeno da se svaki telesni nabor vidi. I to više u stvari uopšte nije privlačno. Te mučenice ne znaju u stvari. Ja sam muškarac, ja nisam nikakav anđeo. Meni je uvek privlačnije bilo da vidim ženu, devojku, onako ipak u nekoj haljini, pa nešto malo, pa malo i da zamišljam kako je sve to. A nekad ti sve onako ne jeste, da...
Znači, nema više otmenosti, sve je sad seksualnost.
Nema otmenosti, nema tajne. Nema one, da te ono zaintrigira malo, pa da, znate. I ona misli da će tako privući. Pa zna se koga će privući taka devojka? Onoga koji je još jeftiniji od nje, koji nikada neće biti dobar muž, koji nikada neće biti dobar otac, koji nikad neće biti ni dobar čovjek na poslu. Znači, ona u stvari već izabira za sebe čovjeka koga će omrznuti jednog dana, od koga će se razvesti, gdje će biti alimentacija, frke, ludila sa decom.
Oče, Arsenije, ja mislim da je uzrok svemu tome zapravo usamljenost. Da tako ljudi hoće da privuku...
To ste dobro rekli, ali ne usamljenost ljudska, nego usamljenost nemamo Boga više. Jer čovjek može biti sam na celoj planeti, ali kad ima Boga, to mimo nas je i svaki hrišćan bi to trebao da zna. Znači, ta usamljenost, to osjećanje usamljenosti, što ste rekao, to je ključna stvar, to ste jako dobro rekli. Ali usamljenost u stvari u svojoj ljušturi nemanja tog tvorca koji nas je stvorio i koji nam udahnuo život.
Zato ljudi uništavaju svoje tijelo, prave te piercinge, tetovaže, bande to rade da bi se prepoznavali.
Da bi se prepoznavali, jer vidite, jedan čovjek koji nosi ozbiljnu, jaku ličnost u sebi, koji ima šta da, koji ima harizmu, znate, on će svojom ličnošću, on će svojim harizmom, svojim intelektom da deluje i da pleni ljude. A mi koji smo prazni, jadni, koji nemamo šta da ponudimo, mi ćemo da pravimo cirkus u sebe, ne bi li nekoga privukli i opet to nikad ništa nije, znate. To je jedna duboka nesreća u stvari. Znači, zato moramo da radimo na svojim dušama, na svojim duhovima, na svojim ličnostima, a na telima lako ćemo. Bog nas je napravio, svi smo, moj najružniji čovjek u stvari, lep kada nosi Boga u sebe, znate.
He was talking about how they protect their women, they're not out there flaunting. Yeah, so this he was honoring actually the Muslim woman.
Yeah.
Which if you look into the Quran, there's a whole chapter named after Mary, the mother of Jesus. And that's what I want to talk to you a little bit about now. What's your relationship with Jesus now? Because that's what it comes out. Christianity is all based about Jesus, right?
Well, he's messenger of Allah. He's our brother.
So you still believe in him?
Oh, definitely. We love Jesus Christ.
Absolutely.
We love Jesus Christ. He's our brother, actually.
Yeah.
And, you know, he's a respectful messenger of Allah.
Mm-hmm.
We don't have problem with
one of the greatest messengers that Allah sent.
Definitely, and I think you told that in one of your shows that we actually love Jesus Christ more than Christians.
Mm-hmm. We follow him more.
Yeah, definitely.
We just did the greeting. Salamu alaykum. Shalamu alaykum. Yeah, peace be with you. Definitely. How he prayed. You pray like Jesus prays now. He fell on his face.
Definitely. And definitely.
He prayed.
Yeah,
right?
But you know.
He didn't pray like this or like
his face on the
ground.
People love to cover, you know.
Yeah. The truth,
the,
yeah.
The truth, really.
When you tell this to, when you say, hey, just tell me, where are you going? Sit down, the popri chama. When you talk to people, connected these similarities ever, and do people like, does that draw them in when you talk about how we love Jesus as a mighty messenger?
Yeah,
we just
say
he didn't say he was God. I'm not going to worship him.
Definitely.
He never said he was God.
No, definitely.
Right? So have you had when you tell people, I still love Jesus, where are you going with this stuff? I love him more than you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, people used to have, you know, people are, you know, surprised.
Yeah. But that's the information we need to get out.
Of course.
Yeah. And that's why we do these programs like this, so people can see, like, we're not following a religion from outer space.
May Allah reward you for your efforts, really.
Yeah. I mean, you too.
You do great job.
Alhamdulillah. We're trying.
Great job.
We're trying.
Ordinary people. This is definitely, the Deen Show is beautiful.
Alhamdulillah. Tell me, before we cut out, for a friend of mine, like, you know, I was talking about my former student, Tony, and others who are out there, And particularly we want to reach out to the Serbian people, Croatian, and everybody. Basically, Islam transcends the nationalism. What advice do you have for them in closing that can kind of, they can relate to you? It's one thing I'm talking, but they can see Alexander, you know, he...
Don't listen to people.
Yeah.
You know, don't listen to people. Just open your heart. But, you know, and you will meet your Creator, definitely. Mm-hmm. And you will understand the purpose of life, beauty of Islam, and the beauty of this religion, mm-hmm. really. This is religion, the only truthful religion, religion of peace, definitely, mm-hmm. and religion who will make you actually life here easier and hereafter definitely better.
Absolutely.
Well, and, of course, watch the Dean Show.
Watch the Dean Show. You actually, can we get you? You are singing the theme song. This is the...
This is the Dean Show.
MashaAllah. one more thing I want to cut out with. We really encourage... There's a statement from the last and final messenger. Obviously, as Muslims, we believe that the Creator sent messengers out of his love to guide humanity. And Muhammad is just the last final messenger. And he talked about that every human being is misguided. Right? Yep. That Allah is saying that every human being is misguided unless I guide them, meaning Allah guides them. So ask me, pitam is a moj, how you say guidance?
Uput.
Mm-hmm. And we firmly believe that if you ask God Almighty alone for guidance, for
definitely, you will get answers.
Yeah, we encourage people definitely. To go directly to the Creator to ask. And as a former, well, you weren't really, you know, a lot of Serbians, they're connected to Orthodox Christianity. Yeah. Now, there is a prayer there. It's called the Lord's Prayer.
Yes.
In English, it goes like this. O our Father, who art in heaven,
yes.
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. You know what's very, Alexander, you know what's very interesting about this, right? That, you know, the scholars, you know, they talk about if you just take ab in Arabic, you go rab. So, O our Lord. Yeah. If you connect it, it's so similar to the Al-Fatiha, because in here, it's praising. Your kingdom, meaning all that belongs to you, right? And then you have your will be done.
Yeah, there's the meaning of Al-Fatiha.
Your will. How do you say your will?
Tvoja volja.
Yes. No. This is Islam.
Yes.
So when they stick to this and they call on God alone and they say, guide me, if they're sincere, Allah will guide them.
Definitely.
Isn't that right?
Yes.
So we encourage everyone to connect, to really think, because you saw death in the face and that motivated you, right?
Yeah.
Some definitely. People, too much, you know, games, entertainment, party, music, and their minds are numb and they're not thinking.
Yeah.
But like you said, death is a reality. Time is short.
Time is short, really.
So we really need to take the matter serious, because at the end, your nationality is not going to get you into paradise, right?
Definitely.
But it's your belief and your deeds. And I want to thank you.
Thank you.
May
so
Allah
much.
The Creator bless you and thank you. I mean, I thank you. Hopefully, inshallah, all the viewers can benefit from your experiences.
You too, and all Muslims.
Ameen.
Definitely. And all good people and our translator, definitely.
Watch the Dean Show.
Watch the Dean Show.
Watch the Dean Show.
Make sure you watch the Dean Show.
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 Watch the Dean Show.